Hey guys, it's Alicia James, and I am where you ought to be, and that's right here with LB.
When you feel your heart's guarded, and you see the break started, when the clouds have all departed, you'll be right here with me.
Dog child.
Crazy, crazy in love with you. Oh, what's up, YouTube? It's your boy LB, and welcome to a special episode of Right Here with LB. Now, I'm fresh back off the plane from hot Atlanta. Man. And this is my first time being out there, and I gotta tell y'all, I enjoyed myself. I really did. Got this shirt out there, you know what I'm saying? I think it's kind of nice. I had to come back, and I'm back on the stairs once again, one last time for you guys, because my new set isn't ready yet, so I had to come back to the old set to catch up with Alicia James. Y'all may remember her from my first season. I believe she was on episode number 5 of my first season. Just for y'all that may not have seen that, check out this clip.
Cop that. I'm telling you, cop that. So, Ms. James, before we let you go, before we let you get up out of here, because we know you're a very busy woman, if you can, go ahead and hit us with, you know, a little live vocal, darling. me, you. Go ahead and hit us with a little bit. Let us know what you got. Let's see what you got.
Sure. I'll sing a little bit of my single. How many times will you apologize to me, and will you just continue to hurt me? I guess I'll take you back once again, 'cause I don't want this relationship to end. I'm crazy.
Man, I had so much fun having that lady on my show, because not only is she a friend to the show, she's a personal friend to LB. And I really, really appreciate her not only doing my first season, because it was, you know, fighting tooth and nail to get some people, you know, to try on the show. She's definitely supporting me, and I support her to the fullest. Let's go ahead and get down to the nitty gritty of the whole thing. Like I said, it's a special episode. Don't want to, you know, go on too long. Plus, we want to make sure y'all get to hear the song at the end of the episode. So, let's start with the first question. First question is, which one came first, Alicia? I want to know personally. Was it the title, or was it the song?
Well, actually, with this song, as soon as I heard the instrumental, the lyrics started flowing. So the song came first and then the title afterwards. Now, usually when I write, I usually try to come up with the title first and then write the lyrics. So Crazy in Love is special. It's my special baby.
Okay. And see, and that's what I said. Some people do title, then song. Some people do song and then the title. So it's good to know that in this case, the song actually came prior to the title. All right, question number 2. What is the inspiration behind this song? Because Crazy in Love is deep. Like, that's not no ordinary love, right? Like, Beyonce did her Crazy in Love, and she was acting up in the video. This is your Crazy in Love, which is a little different, but still Crazy in Love nonetheless. So where did the inspiration for this particular song come from?
Well, the inspiration for this song is so funny. I call myself a nosy writer, and what that means is that I write from other people's experiences, like my friends or stories that I've heard. I know a lot of people ask me, you know, are you writing about your life or your relationship or, you know, whatever? I really don't. It's really rare when I do that. Most of the time, I'm just like being nosy. But it's actually the short version. It's about a friend's relationship. She was with this guy who wasn't ready to settle down. He was out on the street doing his own thing. And you know how friends can be. We were all like, girl, why are you with him? You need to leave him. You know how we get. And she just looked at us one day and was like, I love him. And I was like, wow, okay. She really meant it. Like, it didn't matter. And, you know, we've all been there. So that's when I came up with Crazy Love.
Okay, she says a nosy writer. I wonder if the friend that you wrote the song about actually knows the song is about them. And then as a personal friend of yours, I'm going to be checking out your other music, see if it fits any of my situations. So going on to the next question. I really want to know, how long ago did you write this song? Sometimes artists will pull a song from years and years ago, and it fits better today than it did back then. So then they'll pull that old song and then break it, you know, in the present day, as opposed to, you know, trying to do it back then. So how long ago did you write this song, and how long have you actually been trying to break it?
That's a good question. I rarely keep up with that. No, but I wrote the song around February, and I actually recorded it in April. So it's pretty new. People are just now starting to hear it. I'm getting a lot of great feedback, and the actual release is going to be in June. So y'all stay tuned.
Okay, so this song isn't really old. Okay, that's understandable. That's actually pretty good that it's doing so well, and it's a new song to you. Like, it's really a new song to you, as opposed to just being new to us as the audience or as your fans. Next question is, why did you choose this song to be your first single as opposed to some of your other original music?
This is gonna be so cheesy, but it's true. Crazy in Love to me is a really, really special song. I've wrote so many songs, and one, for example, called Stop Playing. A lot of people really love that song. They really, really do. And everyone probably thought that that would be my first single, but I love Stop Playing, but when I wrote Crazy in Love, I just connected with this song. Like, I instantly knew that this is a song that I wanted to introduce Alicia James to represent me as an artist. So that's kind of how it came to be.
Okay, I can understand that there's a connection, you know, with certain songs versus other songs. It's crazy that you connected with this song, considering that this isn't your situation that you're writing about. Typically, the connection is because you have literally a personal connection with the song or the lyrics that you're writing. But considering this is about a friend or someone else's situation, the connection is a little bit different. But hey, a connection nonetheless. So I can definitely dig that. Alright, well, before we get into the single and everything, because I know everybody's going to dig it, let's go ahead and let them know where they can find it, where they can download it, or, you know, whatever. Let them know exactly where they can hear this song or where they can get your music.
You can actually find the song on my official site, MissAliciaJames.com, and also on any of the major social sites, MySpace, Alicia James Music, Facebook, Alicia James, Reverb Nation, you can find it there. It'll be available for download in June, so y'all watch out for that.
Okay, folks, there we have it. Just like she said, you can peep the song, you can pick it up, you can download it off her MySpace page, her Reverb Nation page, her YouTube page as well, or you can go to MissAliciaJames.com, and you can also pick that information up there. Now, it's sad to say, but that's all the questions I have for you, Alicia. I mean, I'm pretty sure this now gives, you know, a all-around view on where this song came from, what the song is about. Now all we got to do is let them hear it. So I really appreciate you coming. I mean, thank you so much.
I had such a great time. LB, I just want to thank you so much for letting me be on your show again for the second time. I feel so special and loved. But I really appreciate it. And like I said before, I think what you're doing is really special. A lot of the artists are going to appreciate it. I love you so much. Peace. Natural chick epidemic.
Thank you so much. Hey, y'all heard her. June 2010. Pick it up. Natural chick epidemic. That's her tag. That's her following. She doing her thing. Alicia James. Now, I know y'all are wondering, hey, it looks like it's the end of the episode. Where the song at? I want to hear the song. Well, as opposed to just playing the song for you guys, we put together a video. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and put a link. The link is going to be to the left. And this, and the information, or actually, nope, YouTube has switched it up. It's probably down here at the bottom now. So there's going to be a link to the video. So go ahead, check out the video. Thank you for checking me out. I love you guys, and I can't wait to see you guys for season two. I got a lot of stuff coming, a lot of surprises, some banging artists, even some people from Atlanta that I had the chance to network with while I was out there. So thank you so much for checking me out. Oh, and again, if you want to follow me, you want to stalk me, you want to be a fan, whatever you want to do, it's all good. You can check me out on Twitter right here. You can check me out on Facebook. And of course, you can check me out on MySpace. But you can always catch me right here on YouTube, and I'm out.
Be right here with me. B-Rock. Dog Child. V-Bag.
You'll be right here with me. Oh, 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 oh. life is going too fast. Off the train tracks, I can slow it down.